All right, this video is basically how I prepare ribs when I'm in a hurry. These are beef ribs, and what I've done is I've removed the membrane, like I always do, cleaned off the, you know, the excess, the hard fat balls that you'll find underneath the membrane, and then I went ahead and sliced these, and you'll see why I sliced them in a few minutes here. Like I said, this is what I do when I'm not going to be barbecuing ribs on my smoker. I'm going to be preparing these on my Weber. And it's just a kind of a quick and easy way to make some, you know, really good ribs that they taste like they've been smoked for 6 hours. So anyway, what I'm going to do now is just apply some rub to my meat. I know some people don't like to apply rub to beef ribs, but I do, so I'm going to. So anyway, get back to you in a sec. Okay, so I'm going to be cooking my ribs here in a few minutes. So I wanted to show you how I have my coals set up on my Weber. As you can see, I have the coals arranged so they're very tight to one side of the kettle, so I can use indirect heat. What I've done is I've taken a small log of hickory, the type I usually use on my smoker, and I've split it up into small pieces. And I'm going to arrange these here in the bed of coals. Always keep one of these tongs to help me arrange my wood and my coals, so it's a good idea. Alrighty, so as you can see now, the wood is fully engulfed in flames, and it's time to arrange the meat on the grate. And the reason I sliced the ribs was so that I could arrange them in a half, you know, like a semicircle around the edge here to keep them away from the heat source. I am going to be using, you know, indirect heat throughout this whole entire cook. And this first part is basically just smoking them. Right now I'm going to put the lid on. As you can see, I have the vent holes fully open, and they're over the meat, right on top of the meat. This way the smoke will be forced to come through the meat in order to exit the lid here, so we're going to fully penetrate that meat. I also have the vents fully opened on the bottom of the Weber, so I'm getting a nice good airflow. I'm just going to keep it smoking like this for about 30-40 minutes, and then I'm going to apply the sauce. It's been about 40 minutes now, and we're ready to baste the ribs with the barbecue sauce. So as you can see, I've got really, really good color, like you'd expect to see from, you know, smoked ribs off the pit. Also, the meat's starting to recede a little bit from the bone, which is a good sign. And I'm just going to baste these on both sides, try to get as much sauce on here as I can. So as you can see, I've now got my the ribs all nice and glazed. And another thing I did was I added some more wood to my fire, and I just, again, took nice sticks of hickory and laid it across the coals. Coals were starting to wither out, and this is just going to kind of bring them back to life. And again, it's not going to over smoke the ribs because they're not going to be on there that long. I've got another 30-40 minutes of cooking time at the most on these, so I'm going to let these get to till they're fully engulfed in flames. I'm going to get the lid back on the Weber and just let it do its thing. So be back with you in about 40 minutes. Right, it's been about 35 minutes now, and I gave these ribs a peek, and they are done. So I'm going to go ahead and pull them. As you can see, the sauce is nice and glazed and bubbling away, so these things are looking good, smelling great. Okay, so I'm going to take these in, let them cool down just a bit, and then I think what I'm going to do is slice into one so you can see how much smoke ring we got. So anyway, this is the end result. You can see they're just nicely glazed and smells awesome. And I'm hoping that this will show up on video. Usually I'm not too happy with the color that I get, but you can see even though I cook these things relatively quickly, you know, as far as barbecue is concerned, I still have a really nice dark smoke ring going around the edge of the meat here. So anyway, these things are still very moist, juicy, and awesome smoke flavor. So that's how I do ribs when I do them on the Weber, and I hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks.